question says, your vest, does it have a living animal or a living creature, Lacoste, or however you say it or pronounce it? Is it permissible to wear these types of things? We say first and foremost, there lies no doubt that the Prophet commanded with the destruction and the effacing of Surah and Tamathi. And there's a reason why I mentioned the two terms in Arabic. Not like some other brothers that give these talks and khutbahs in which they mention all of these different words in Arabic to people that don't speak Arabic. Nah, we're not talking about that. Quoting the hadith in Arabic, that's fine. Quoting the ayah in Arabic, of course. Mentioning some speech from some of the ulama, mentioning the whole paragraph, but just to say different terms and words to make your speech seem as if it has content in it. No, that's not the purpose. But it's the reason why. I'm going to get to the answer specifically, and that is that the word timthal, as we took in the F class, has a meaning. And the word surah also has a what? A meaning. There's no doubt, according to most of the ulama, Jumahir al-Salaf al-Khalaf, most of the ulama of past and present hold the view that sculptures and paintings and carvings of 3D, three dimensions of a living thing that has blood and breath is unlawful to do. Unlawful to make and to construct. Some of the ulama of the past, they held the view that it's unlawful to take or make any surah, image, idol, whatever, anything of a tree, anything that's living, of Allah's creation, even mountains. They say you can't do this. Everybody understand this? And there's even a view, which is a view of very, very, very minority of ulama, of it being permissible. We're not even going to deal with that. Everybody understand this? Of the actual surah or the timthal that is made by hand. That is what? Made by hand. A carving, a sculpting, bronze statue. Everybody understand this? And also a painting that's made by hand. Everybody clear on this? Now, move on to the 20th century or 21st century. A photograph. Is it permissible to take a photograph of a human being? Is it permissible to take a photograph of a dog or a cat or a cougar or a panther or a tiger or an elephant or an alligator, crocodile? Is it permissible to do this? Also, do you have to destroy it? Or is that talking about something that's 3D? And something that was made by what? Human means, imitating the law's creation. Everybody clear on this? Or anything, whether it's 2D, 1D, however dimensions, however written, drawn. But if it's something that's living, it must be scratched out and defaced. And at least the head is removed, the neck is separated from the head, and the eyes are removed, etc. Everybody understand this? So, we're clear on that in the past. As far as the present, do you take a photograph in Islam? Is it permissible to take a photograph in Islam? Is a photograph considered a surah? Is a photograph considered a timthal, a taghut? These are the names that are mentioned in the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ regarding idols and sculptures, and maybe even some things that are drawn on a flat surface. Everybody understand this? So some of the ulama and pictures have a direct connection to the question. They say that it's the same ruling, maybe even worse, and it's haram to take a picture, absolutely. And some of them may say it's permissible out of necessity or extreme need. Out of what? Extreme need. And other ulama, they say that it's not haram. That a photograph or video is not the same as someone sculpting something, someone painting something, someone drawing something, someone using their natural talent, even though it takes talent in photography as well, but the talent of the hand in making an image of something. Everybody understand this? Let alone if it's done mechanically, if it's done, or if it's a picture of an animal, something that's not even real, like a ninja turtle. It was a book bag I had one of my children in Yemen, and I asked the sheikh there about this, and I showed him the book bag. He said, this isn't real life. There are no turtles that walk around like men with masks on and weapons. Lord, I'm sheikh. You never been to the sewers of New York City? He said, what? He said, what? He said, this isn't a real type of thing. It's not an actual type of turtle crawling. It's a turtle man type of thing. It's a different ruling. Everybody clear on this? So therefore, if you now, for argument's sake, all right, Mufti, you did pin and dodge around the question long enough. If you look closely on my vest, the head and the eyes are what? No, don't zoom in. There, it's blocked. It's totally, it's what? What is it, Nafis?
Did you take a marker to it?
Ah. Headed. So I'm not just wearing a vest with an alligator on it or the brand name that you mentioned, but I actually did what? Efface it. Whether it was haram or halal. Whether it was this view or another view. Clear, inshallah? Whether it was or whether it wasn't, I actually did what? So move it up to the camera, that way you can see that. Inshallah. Khair, inshallah? Walhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. Hopefully clear. Whether it was halal or what? Or haram, I actually got? Khair, inshallah.